11 years, and since 3 years I am working in Hadoop implementation projects as a solution owner in a MNC company. And actually I am, earlier my experience was in SSIS and C Sharp, Java and ETL tools, and specifically in the Agile methodology implementations apart from the Hadoop project implementation. This is brief about myself. Just I would like to know the what year Rao and Page, right? Okay, just I would like to know about yourself. First Rao, can you please tell me about yourself? And just wanted to know about the background and why we are going to, you are looking for the Hadoop training.
I have, it's around 10 years experience in IT, and the complete experience as a ETL developer and ETL lead like that. It's like data stage and SAS, talent. These three tools I worked in this 10 years.
Yeah, nice. Okay.
Yeah,
you have any idea about the Hadoop, or this you don't know anything in the Hadoop?
In the Hadoop level, technically, I don't know any. I don't have any idea. But the thing is, just I saw some more videos in the demo videos in the Google. That's all. So basically, I have the 0% knowledge on Hadoop.
Yeah. Fine. Rao. Okay. Thank you. Teja. Teja, please.
Hello.
Yeah, please go ahead, Teja.
Can you hear me, Sridhar?
Yeah, Teja. Please,
yeah,
go ahead.
So I just graduated from Northern Illinois University in Chicago, and I have looking for like a job in Hadoop and all. So I am a graduate in computer science. I did my bachelor's in computer science and master's in computer science. Regarding knowledge about Hadoop, I think I should be in the same level as Rao, because I have only seen a few videos here and there, and I've tried to actually practice by myself, but that couldn't happen. So that's the reason why I'm actually taking this class.
Yep, okay, Teja, okay. And just first I would like to, 1 second. Both, are you able to see my screen, right?
Yeah, I'm able to see the screen.
Okay, first big data. Okay. Basically, big data is a concept. How we can compare like OOPs. OOPs is a concept. We can achieve the OOPs concept by using the C++, C#, Java, Python like that, right? So in the same way, big data is a concept. We can achieve the big data concept by using the Hadoop technology. Hadoop is the one and only technology as of now in the market to achieve the big data concept. What is the big data? Before going to big data, we need to discuss about the 4 V's. Velocity, volume, variety, finally veracity. Here 4 V's. These we need to consider as part of the big data concept. Velocity means it's a huge volume of that data is continuously coming into the system. Since how data is getting prepared, coming nowadays through sensors. I'm talking about the huge data. Even normal data we can get the applications likewise, but huge data will be generated through sensors, CC cameras, Social networks like Facebook, Twitter, like that. Social network kind of stuff, and airlines, etc. These are the some examples which are producing a huge data, and frequency also very high produce while producing the data, and volume in this very huge kind of data. Variety, we have the variety of data. It is the PDF format, Word format, Excel format, and image format also. In the image also, PDF, so many formats are there. So variety of formats data will be available in the system. Veracity means dependable data. What is the one data will be dependent on another data. One data is input as to the another data. Likewise, in this dependable data, what is the useful data to take the any decision? High level management to take the decision. What is the useful data based on the dependency of the data? These four V's will togetherly known as big data concept. So to achieve this big data concept, we are going to adopt the technology called Hadoop. This is the concept of Hadoop overview, and actually we are having the data in the form of gigabytes, terabytes, exabytes, petabytes, petabytes, like this. In the gigabytes, we can handle the gigabytes of data using any RDBMS, right? And Rao and Teja, if you have any doubts and anything else, just stop me and ask, okay? Just I am going through.
Yeah, all right, go ahead.
Okay. In gigabytes, we can handle the gigabytes of data using the RDBMS. It can be SQL Server, Oracle, MySQL, whatever, the RDBMS can handle the gigabytes. Terabytes of data can handle, there is a technology called Teradata. More than Teradata, there is no technology earlier. Now we have the Hadoop technology to handle the petabytes and above that data. Okay, so now how it will handle this huge volume of data in Hadoop? We have different ecosystems in the Hadoop ecosystems. So mainly Hadoop is for storing and processing. Storage the huge data, huge volume of data, and as well processing that storage data. So we have a component called HDFS for storage. We have called MapReduce for processing. These are the main components of the Hadoop. Hadoop is for storage and processing. If you want, just note it down also, Rao and Teja. Actually, I am giving the running notes also, which is very useful. And one more thing, just my this introduction and this training is always like kind of interview oriented. So each, whatever the concept I am explaining, what are the possible interview questions on that particular concept, I will give you. It's almost writing the notes, it's better. Okay, so Hadoop is for both storage and processing purpose. We can address the storage issue using the HDFS component, HDFS one component, and we can address the processing stuff using the MapReduce component. We have so many Hadoop ecosystems like Hadoop ecosystems, HDFS, then MapReduce, then Hive, HBase, Scoop, OG, Zookeeper, Dig, Flume. And also I will give Spark and Scala introduction part. Basics. Basics of Spark and Scala. Each component is having its own purpose. Suppose HDFS, it is for storage the data. MapReduce, we can process the storage data which is available on the HDFS. Hive is data warehouse kind of component where we can store the data in the form of tabular format, rows and columns. And HBase is a kind of NoSQL database. It is a column-oriented database where we can perform the crude operations, read and write operations also. Where we cannot perform the read and write operations on the HDFS and IL, but we can perform the read and write operations on the HBase. Scope, it is a connector between the RDBMS and Hadoop. We can import the data from the RDBMS kind of SQL Server, Oracle, MySQL, DB2. Likewise, RDBMS database, we can import the data from RDBMS table to the HDFS. And in the reverse way also, we can export the data from the Hadoop to the RDBMS tables. Like a OG, Zookeeper, Footpeak, Flume, Spark, each component is having its own purpose. I will explain later one by one. Okay, these are the high-level Hadoop introduction. I will go how it will work. Suppose in earlier days, for example, take the 1970s. Suppose 1.3 GB data. My internet speed is, let's example, 4.4 Mbps. To take the download the 1.3 GB data by using the 4.4 Mbps network, almost it takes 5 minutes in the earlier. I am talking about in the early olden days, around 1970s. But day by day, data is getting increased. It's a volume, gigabytes, terabytes. For example, let's assume 1 terabyte. Let's say our Mbps speed is 100 Mbps. It will take almost 2.5 hours, right? In 1970s, I am talking about 1 terabyte. If you download 1 terabyte of data using the 100 Mbps, it will take 2.5 hours. To minimize this 2.5 hours to 1.5 hour, what I can do here, max I can make it 100 Mbps to 1000 Mbps. In that case also, how much I can download, max 1.5 hours, still 1.5 hours. I cannot go down from 1.5 hours time. But here, Hadoop come into the picture, it will max in hours to the minutes. How? How means in the parallel manner. Concept is in the parallel manner. What means, in our layman example, suppose one man can do one work in 10 days, 5 men can do in the 2 days. It is a layman example. Likewise, suppose there is a we need to clean one room, each corner is having taken 2 minutes, four corners it will take the 8 minutes. Suppose four members will clean, each member will clean each corner, we can clean the room in the 2 minutes. Just it's a parallel, we are doing the processing in the parallel manner. 1 terabytes of data, we can store that 1 terabytes of data in the 10 missions, 1024 1024 1024 GB. Likewise, we can store that 1 terabytes data in the n number of multiple missions. We can process the same data in the parallel manner. That is, we can call it as a cluster. Cluster. Before going to this cluster, suppose take the traditional applications. What are the common things we can expect in the traditional applications? Node failures. There is a chance in the node failures in the traditional applications. If any node failure, what's happening? Data will be lost. Data lost. Third one is network issues. As already discussed like this here, network issues. Network and bandwidth issues. So to address these concerns, we are going for the cluster. The concept introduced in the Hadoop technology implementation is a cluster. Means use data will be distributed among the cluster. Use data. Actually, I don't have any PPTs. I will prepare actually. So by showing those PPTs, you can understand easily how it will be. But I am preparing the PPTs also. But more time, I am not using any of this present. I will go through the all real time in the Linux process and all. I don't want to go for more presentation kind of stuff. Huge volume of data will be distributed among the missions. So cluster itself we can call as a collection of missions in the distributed manner, in the common network. Cluster means it is a collection of missions in the common network. So that we can distribute the data among all the missions in the cluster. That is the where we can storage our huge volume of data. Distributed among the huge volume of data will be distributed among the missions. This is called the cluster. Collection of missions. Cluster is a collection of missions. Missions in the common network. Oh, this is all about the cluster. Rao Teja, is there anything about the cluster? You got any idea or any confusion like this? Just let me know. We will go with the interactive session likewise.
So clusters are basically the places where you store the data, or are those the computers which they are computers, right?
Yeah, they are the missions only.
I mean, they're not computers, or there's no one working on them.
Computers only.
Okay, so my doubt is, will those computers be used for processing only or used for storage of data also?
No, here that's what the beauty of the Hadoop is.
Okay.
Basically, in the traditional applications, it is raw or Teja? Is it? Ah, Teja. In general, take the traditional applications. How they will work traditional application? We will develop one application in the Java or Python, C Sharp, whatever. Okay, we will develop the one application, and this data will suppose take the Oracle database. Backend is the Oracle database. That database will come to this application. We will connect together, right? But whereas here in the Hadoop cluster, we will distribute the huge volume of data along with the machines which are connected with the common network. Suppose take the 1 terabyte of data, suppose 5 terabytes of data, let's assume. So there is a 5 machines cluster I have, 1 terabyte in one first mission, second mission to 1 terabyte, likewise 5 machines having, each mission is having 1 terabyte data, and all are connected each other. They are connected in the one common network that is called as a cluster. Now what's happening is, in the Hadoop is having both Hadoop, each mission is having HDFS to storing the data and MapReduce to process the data. Each node is having, in the cluster we are calling it as a node. Each mission is calling as a node. So by default, each node is having HDFS, both HDFS and MapReduce components. HDFS is for storing the data, and MapReduce is for processing the data.
Okay, I understand. So all these nodes will have both HDFS and MapReduce.
Correct. All. Suppose I have 100 nodes in my cluster. Each node is having both HDFS and MapReduce. Here, difference is HDFS is for storing the data. MapReduce is for processing that particular data.
All right, okay.
Whenever we install the Hadoop, both these MapReduce and HDFS components are installed by default. Rest of the components, as I told, Hive, HBase, Coop, we need to install externally, but these two by default they are installed in each node, not only single node. Getting, Teja?
Yes, I understand. Thank you.
Rao, you got it?
Yeah, I have small doubts here.
Yes.
I am comparing to some other tool based on that only I am getting easily.
Yeah.
For example, if I take the any ETL tool like DataState, if I am, for example, my source is Oracle, target also is Oracle.
Source is Oracle.
I'm going to extract, yeah, the target is like Oracle, maybe whatever it may be.
Okay.
I have huge data in the source. I'm extracting the source data, then process it and load it into the target database. Like, for example, DB2 is the target database.
Correct. Sorry. That is called as ETL, extract, transformation, loading.
In between. Teja is asking something.
Sridhar, there is a lot of echo when we are speaking.
Pardon me?
Echo. We are able to hear our own. It is repeating again and again.
So my voice is repeating more times, right?
No, not yours. Our voice. I think. Are you on speaker or something like that?
Just general speaker I am.
So we are able to hear our own voice. I mean, we are not able to understand clearly what each other is speaking.
Okay. Tomorrow onwards, I will use microphones.
Okay? Yeah, okay, sure. Sorry to interrupt.
Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah, Rao, go ahead, please.
Once extract the chameleon records from the source with the help of ETL tool, you need to process the source data in the with the help of parallelism, like of nodes. If I am going to mention that in the tool properties, mention four nodes. The complete source data is to be split in the four routes, in the four parallel. For parallel process. But my doubt is the complete, even if I am mentioning the node configuration, so it is under the data structure tool, right? But here you are telling us some missions, separate missions like that.
Yeah, actually data is distributed among the missions, among the nodes. All are connected together. All are in the same network. Suppose HDFS is a shared, suppose there is a one file, a dot log file is in the node 1. This node 1 HDFS, this can be available, this can be accessible from other nodes also, because they are connected each other, they are shared, they are in the distributed manner. Okay? So once we are, once we kept the a dot log file in the one node, this a dot log file will be available across the network, across the cluster. So that what's happening is the architecture itself, how once we are getting into the coding and all, you will come to know in detail, Rao. What's happening is, in the tradition, as you told, traditional applications are client server manner. Architecture itself a client server architecture, right?
Yeah, correct.
But in the Hadoop, it is not a client server architecture. It is a master slave node. Master slave node architecture it is. There is a master node is there, which controls all the n number of nodes. These n number of nodes are called as a slave nodes, where slave nodes can have the HDFS and MapReduce programs.
Yeah, now I got it.
Yeah, where we want to process the data, each individual node is having its own HDFS, and each individual node having its own MapReduce. So that's what parallel work has been done. So instead of doing everything in the single shot, each one doing in the separate in the parallel manner, once all nodes are getting completed the task, the master node is consolidated the entire work and give back the result to the client.
Okay.
Getting, Rao?
Yeah, now I got it.
Yeah, okay. So where we are, okay, this suppose we are in traditional manner client server, right? Here we are calling it the architecture as master slave server, slave architecture. So this what are the master, what are the slave, what is the purpose of the slave nodes, what are the functioning of the slave nodes, what slave node, each slave node contains, and what master node contains, what is the functioning of master, I will explain you in the detail, okay, in the next sessions.
Okay.
All right.
This is all about the just introduction part, Rao and Desh. If anything, just in this, we have any doubts about the what is the Hadoop projects and what is the advantages, all these things. Any doubts in the mind? Just let me know. We will have a discussion in the next 15 minutes.
I have a question about the course.
Yeah.
So how long is this course going to take?
Yeah, actually, I am planning for 45 hours.
Okay.
Weekend, it depends on, suppose weekends, if we sit more than 1 hour, 2 hours, likewise also, I don't have any problem. will make it, I will can make it 45 hours. It may be plus 5 hours like that only. It depends on our discussions and our interactions and all.
Alright.
45 to 50 hours, it may increase. If we have more interactive sessions and more discussions, it will be prolonged.
Okay, sure, okay.
And one more thing is, actually, as of now, Hadoop is CCA 140 certifications are available. This is expired also, that is. Now CCA 175 is there. Just in 2 months back, I have done that CCA 175, which is a Hadoop and Spark developer program, which is very, actually in the earlier certifications, multiple choices are there, but the CCA 175, we need to implement the program in the Cloudera as CDH5.
Okay.
So, once we have a certification, it will be a very added value for us.
Okay, so you think this course will get us into, I mean, get us to...
Yeah, correct, definitely, definitely. And to be frank, whatever I am giving and whatever I am giving the stuff, almost 1.5 to 2 years guy is a developer having how much experience and how much exposure, that much I am giving. On top of basics, on top of that, how we need to explore more around this. Hope you understand.
Yeah, I understand. And is there any assignment?
And I will provide a soft copy of material also. Basically, some downloaded copies and some prepared copies I am having. And I will share with you those copies also.
Okay.
And it is purely about the development part. And admin part, I am not that much, but I have a material. Material means just PDFs also, means how to... admin part is a different, I hope you understand. So, I am very much focused on the development area, Hadoop and Spark. Along with the Hadoop components, I will give you Spark and Scala also. So, basic concepts of Spark and Scala. It is very huge demand on the in the market nowadays. Because in the processing aspects, speed aspects, Spark is 100 times faster than the Hadoop general ecosystems.
Yeah, here if any position is come to picture, it's, they should ask that Spark experience.
Pardon me?
Spark and Scala total user, right?
Yeah.
If any requirement Hadoop related, coming to the doctor,
mm-hmm.
the mandatory is experience. Like they are looking for
no.
a Spark and Scala experience as well.
Is it actually not mandatory, but if we have those skills in our say, resume, it's added value. Because nowadays Spark is emerging on top of Hadoop, already Hadoop clusters are there, Hadoop implementations are there in the Hadoop technology already in the production environment, but there is no almost one or two Spark and Scala in the production. They are now migrating to the Spark and migrating means it's additional value. It's not replaced entire Hadoop. Just it's a replaced HDFS is still there. For instead of MapReduce, they are using the Spark. They are planning to migrate because it's a in the aspects of performance, it's 100 times faster than the MapReduce. It's added
so
value.
Instead of
it's underlying technology is also Spark underlying is a MapReduce, but they have improved the performance in the Spark.
Okay.
So Hadoop cluster
so
is
you
there.
Mean to say that instead of MapReduce, they are using Spark in the future.
Correct. But we should learn the
Scala?
Map. Scala is a scripting language to in the Spark. We can use Python or we can use Java or we can use a Scala in the Spark.
Okay.
Spark is a scripting language for Spark engine.
Okay.
Scala is a scripting language in the for the Spark engine. Got it?
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, along with this Hadoop ecosystems, I will give you introduction of basic part of Spark and Scala also.
Okay.
Keja, anything?
No.
But mainly focused areas are HDFS, MapReduce, Hive, HBase, Scope. These are the main focused areas. If you interview, if you will go for any interview, these are the main components they have touched. Actually, in India or maybe you both are based out of?
I'm based out of Los Angeles.
Teja, right?
Yeah.
What, Rao, yours? Pardon?
UK.
UK. Okay. Yep, anyway, there also certification is important, they are considering, but I don't know much how they are, what is the market there. I know market is good there also, but here in India, certification is important, they are considering certification also, but huge demand here. We are getting the interview calls very frequently here.
Okay. One question, will you be providing any assignment sort of thing in this course?
Yeah, each concepts I will give you the one exercise and kind of use case. I will provide you one use case and solution for that use. Here we assignment, not exactly like what we can say, call it as a use case.
Okay, sure.
So suppose once we are completing HDFS, we will go for the use case of HDFS. We can complete the scope, we can go for the use case of scope, likewise.
Alright, wonderful.
And one more thing, suppose in generally we are having the desktop, the Windows desktops or Windows laptops, right? So this Hadoop is all 100% is based on the Linux environment, okay?
Okay.
So we can have actually in the Cloudera University website we can download the VMware itself. It has everything. Okay.
So
Pardon?
I have set up the Hadoop and VMware player right now, so I think I don't.
Yeah, very good. Very good. Even we can download the direct cloud. There is a client in the www.clouderauniversity.com. So it's a free, as it is a Hadoop itself a open source. We can download from the Cloudera and directly we can attach it to the VMware. See here, just I have Cloudera. This I am running. Just I am showing the how it will be. We can download the Ubuntu flavor, Linux Ubuntu or Linux CentOS, whatever. Everything, all are fine. So first, before going into the HDFS commands, one or two hours I will spend within the Linux commands. Then we will go for the HDFS commands. It is a process.
Are you providing the recording sessions or?
Recording sessions, maybe you can contact Srinivas, maybe you can have the recordings also, organize there.
Okay.
So definitely he may provide.
Okay.
Yes, you have set up. Rao, you can download. I will show you, I will tell you how to download and how to set up also in the next sessions. Okay, this is,
okay.
But make sure that you have a VMware in your laptop or desktop.
Okay,
if you don't have, just download from, it's a free open source, right? Freeware, right? You can download from the net.
Okay.
Okay, just today I have done. Just if you have anything to discuss, just we will have a discussion around this.
Are you supporting any, what is it, telephonic service?
Yeah, sure, no problem. That I don't have any problem. If you have that facility and that everything, you will take care. I will support. Definitely
okay,
support.
Okay,
I will give you support. I know what's happening.
Okay, thanks.
And one more thing, just we will go with the interview oriented, boss. Instead of I am not saying I am 100% Hadoop technology. I am not like that, but whatever the 1.5-2 years experience guy, how much he knows, that much knowledge and that much concepts, that much use cases I will give you. And we will go as a interview oriented, each concept, what are the possible interview questions on each topic, likewise.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Teja, anything?
Nothing else, sir. I'm good.
Yeah, okay. Tomorrow we will have a same time, okay? 10 o'clock IST. What's the time now, Teja, for you now?
9:30 a.m.
Okay. For is Rao?
For me, 6 p.m.
Acha, okay. Okay, man. Have a nice day, Rao. Teja, good night.
Thank you.
Okay, right. Bye-bye.
Okay, sir. Good night. Bye, Teja.
Okay.
Good night.